Hello friends, and welcome to our next video. There is another topic which is known as triggers in Salesforce, and triggers are primarily used to automate some operations, and using trigger we can do some task in the trigger as well, and also we need to invoke our classes. See, let's say I create an Apex class. Okay, I go to setup, I go to develop, I go to classes. Now whatever code we have written in these classes and all, so this code will automatically not run. Either we need to go to developer console and do that execute thing which we have done in the previous video, or what we need to do, we need to call that method from a button, like we have used VF page, or we can use a standard button as well, or triggers are used to call that function. So to write a trigger, let's say we have all the triggers here. If you go to the Apex triggers, you will see all the triggers here. So to write a trigger, either you need to go to that object, or if you're using an ID like Eclipse, you can write that inside that. Let's say I want to write a trigger on any of my custom object. So I will go to create, I will go to objects. Let's say I go to any, let's say I go to child. Now here, under child, we have record type, object limits, button, search layout, compact layout, payload, and here we have triggers. So click on new here. API name for child is child double underscore C. Since we have clicked on new trigger from child object, so the object is there. Now trigger is something which fires on any DML operation. It has couple of events. Those are before and after, or after basically. After insert update delete, and there is one more, one is after undelete. Okay, these are events. You can have before insert, before update, before delete, or after insert, after update, after delete. Now these events come where? These events come here. So let's say I want this trigger to fire on before insert. So you are inserting a record in child object, and here is the name perform. So you can give any relevant name as per the requirement that the trigger will perform. So perform calculation on child before insert. Now what we can do, now let's say we have written, either we can write all the code logic inside this trigger itself, or create a class and call that, write a method inside that class and call that class method from trigger. Okay, so then there are a lot of context variable in triggers as well. Let there is something called trigger.new. So if you are writing the trigger on before insert, so the new records which are being inserted will be there inside the trigger.new. It's a list of new records. Similarly, we have trigger.old. Let's say we are writing a trigger on after update, before update. So in that case, we have old records which we are updating. So we can get those old records in trigger.old automatically. Okay. So what you can do, you can either create a variable. Let's say list of child double underscore C, child child list equals to trigger.new. Okay. And then you can call any class or method. Let's say class on child dot method on child, and it takes a list, child list. Okay. So either you can create a list of child list and assign the list to that, or you can directly call this method by passing. Okay. So what this method on child is actually, we are calling this class on child which we have written somewhere. I have not written that, but just for the sake of learning, that there is a class on child written and which has a method on child by name method on child, and we are calling this method accepts a list of child type as a parameter. So we are calling this method and passing our list trigger.new. Okay, so in this one way to invoke our controller for Apex class and by using trigger. Okay, so I think this was all for this video.